What's up, guys? Yo, what's up, guys? Aaron Jackson here, the Tesla Whisperer. And so today we're going to be talking through update 2020.12.5. It's awesome. Yo, before we get into it, I was going through some old footage and came across this. How did we ever think that was going to work? Anyways, back to the update. Update 2020.12.5. It's amazing. I can't wait to get into it. But want to just welcome you back to the channel. And if you're new, I make videos about Tesla. So if you like that kind of thing, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And also, if you like this video, hit the like button. So yeah, let's dig right in. So there are only a couple things in the release notes. The dash cam updates, the supercharging now is going to tell you how many stalls are out of order. I'm really looking forward to that feature on road trips. I think that's going to come in handy. But let's talk about the dash cam. So this update is super cool. First off, because it came from Twitter. So a guy reached out to Elon on Twitter and said, hey, it would be cool to be able to access the Sentry footage on the UI. And Elon said, sure, look forward to the next update or something like that. And now we have it. Like, that is, anyways, let's just look at this. So before this update, you have to get a third-party app on your phone. If you don't have a Wi-Fi hard drive or flash drive, you would literally have to unplug it from the computer and put it into your phone and then view the footage that way. Yes, it was inconvenient, but the app was pretty cool. But I will say that there were a lot of times where I got a notification that there was an event and I just forgot to go back and look at the footage. I didn't have time to pull it out at the moment, and then when I got home, I just forgot about it. And now, just a click of a couple buttons and you're viewing the footage. And so actually, when I first got the app, I'm an Android user, so the app that I was using was Tesla Cam. And when I first got the app, it lined everything up, but you still had to scroll through and find like what the actual event was. But later on, they actually updated it. And so then all you had to do was click event and it would jump ahead in the timeline so you see the actual event. And so at this point, you just have to scroll forward. I'm sure over time, it's just going to, just like the app, improve and improve. And I'm certain that we're going to get that same feature where you're going to be able to just click and it's going to jump to the event. Or if you see the thumbnails, you probably just see the event in the thumbnail. It's just awesome that you have a car that just gets smarter overnight, you know? And we're just gonna keep getting updates and updates and updates. And I do love this. So if you notice, when I tried it out, the footage starts when I'm driving up. Say this event happened, it's not gonna start from the moment of the event. It's actually gonna backtrack quite a bit so you can get the whole story. And I love how all the footage is synchronized, right? And so you can just click between all the scenes and it's all synchronized. It's super simple and intuitive. I love the new graphics. The Sentry mode graphics have completely changed. I have no idea why they changed the branding, but I really like the new Sentry mode. It feels more of like, oh, I'm being recorded. Versus the other one, you had to kind of look at it to know that it was like a camera lens or whatever. So if you just click this, oh boy, yes, and it starts like I was driving, like, so it gives you about a good 4 minutes, 5 minutes. So while I'm testing this out, although we don't have like the automatic stop at stop signs and traffic lights yet, I'm getting warned a lot more than I used to. I rarely got the warning, and on this drive, I got it twice. And it was a really short drive, and so that's pretty cool. But then also, I don't know if you've seen it, but I'll link it up here. There was a video that I did to show that the Tesla just could not handle this certain intersection or this highway merger, I did it a couple times, and I would literally have to hit the blinker and then get over, and then it would kick me out of autopilot, and then it wouldn't merge onto the other highway. But now it's actually learning. Like, it actually feels like it's AI. Like my car is getting smarter, because I did it tonight and it was like flawless. It got over it by itself. Now it still kicked me out towards the end, but it did get over, and it didn't do that before. And so definitely check out that video. Still comes out, but it's just so cool. Like my car is getting smarter in all these different ways, even more than like the release notes let you know. Like there's so many things that are going on in the background, and it's just exciting to discover it. All right, guys, so that's all I have for you. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you're not already, subscribe for more content like this. And also, you should comment and give me some feedback on the new setup. What else do I want to talk about? I don't know.